In my opinion, a smaller, more focused, and more dedicated player base who are given the feedback and the reports that BSG need, in my opinion, is more useful and better for the game long term than a bigger player base that is a lot noisier and has a lot less focused and useful feedback for the game. It's a simple case of quality over quantity. If it's the guys who are against this progress, if it's these guys who are fighting against the game becoming what it was supposed to become, if these are the guys that are leaving and losing interest in the game because it's not going the way that they want it to go in that respect, then perhaps that loss in popularity is for the best in the long term. That is the idea behind the tweet. That is the idea behind what I wanted to say. Guys, how you doing? Thank you very much indeed for coming and checking out this video. Gonna keep it as short as I can. Do this as quickly as possible. Essentially, guys, what I wanted to do was address a tweet that I put out yesterday, 21 hours ago, in fact. It does seem to have gained a lot of attention. Some good, some bad. I mean, the nature of the tweet, you know, it is pretty controversial, I'm not going to lie. And unfortunately, it does seem like the point that I was trying to make was largely missed. Now, whether it was missed on purpose or, you know, I didn't make myself clear enough, I'm not 100% sure. Obviously, there's only so much you can squeeze into 120 characters or whatever it is that Twitter allows. So, you know, it is to be expected that the whole point that I was trying to make, the whole sort of mindset that I have regarding the situation, you know, it hasn't sort of been communicated very well on my part. So for that, you know, obviously we are doing a video today to kind of address these things. So essentially what the tweet says is, it says, Tarkov dying might actually be the best thing to happen to it in years. I mean, look what the popularity boom of patch 12 brought with it. BSG always said Tarkov would be a niche game for a specific target audience. So if we're going back to our roots, that should be celebrated. I did do a little follow-up message because there seems to be a lot of confusion. There seems to be a lot of people not really understanding what I was trying to say. That message says, for those confused about this tweet, Tarkov is an action RPG. Okay, this is the very first genre that is represented on the official website, the official description of the game. Tarkov was never intended to be a fast-paced shooter. Now that is relevant, okay? That is relevant to the overarching idea behind the tweet and my sort of ideas behind how things are going with the community at the moment. Tarkov is designed to simulate real-life combat and SEER. Okay, SEER stands for Survive, Evade, Resist, and Extract. It is a escape and evasion way of training troops, soldiers, to essentially get out of a hostile environment by surviving, evading, resisting capture, and then extracting at the end, you know, getting out of there and everything else. You know, these are the sort of things that you can see happening in Tarkov all the time, okay? The patch 12 boom, the boom in popularity that happened around patch 12, brought in a lot of players who don't understand what Tarkov is, what it's supposed to be, what it was and what it will be. And they're fighting against developmental progress. Now, the reason why I say there are a lot of people fighting against developmental progress is because there are a number of changes that have happened indeed over the years, but there have been a lot of very, very small changes that have happened over the last month or so, maybe 2 months now. Essentially, this wipe. Okay, there's been a lot of changes, there've been a lot of things happening, which many people are quite vocally disagreeing with. Now, one of these things you might say, could be dynamic loot. Okay, so a lot of players are complaining that they're not able to run to the same loot spots all the time. All right, they're not able to farm the same item over and over and over and over again, and you know, run in very efficiently with their loot routes that are perfectly optimized. You know, they know exactly which way to go, pick up very specific items from different places, checking the spawns, boom, 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 very, very efficient, get what they need to get. If there's nothing there, they dip, okay? In and out, 5-10 minutes tops, all right? And they'll do this over and over and over and over and over and over again to amass a huge amount of money or, you know, whatever it is that they're wanting to do. Okay, now this is completely against the idea of Tarkov. It's completely against the idea of not knowing what you're going to be up against, not knowing what's going to be in the different locations, loot locations and whatnot. And this is why dynamic loot, the start of which, and if you remember BSG Nikita's message, this is the start of a series of events, guys. A series of events which will eventually become the dynamic loot system, which we'll see in 1.0. Hopefully before 1.0, okay? I imagine it will probably be finalized before the game fully releases. But, you know, the game's final sort of loot system, okay, will be very, very dynamic and very unpredictable in a lot of ways, okay? This is something that we've known for a long time, and these changes are already coming into effect. So, you know, this is just one change. I'm trying to keep this video as short as I can. I don't want to waffle on for too long. But that's one example of many which is being, or well, are being fought against. You know, a lot of people are against these changes. You know, there's not enough PvP, or there's not enough this, there's not enough that. Like, all these things that happens in Tarkov, but aren't necessarily the main focuses, right? And this is the hard part. This is where that divide starts, really, okay? Because you've got a lot of people who want certain things to happen in the game over and over and over again because that's what they enjoy. You know, we all love PvP. We all love a good fight. We all love, you know, being able to go in and have great fights with other players and stuff like that. However, you know, that's not the main focus of the game, okay? And it all comes back to the description of Tarkov. It is an action RPG. It's an action role-playing game. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that includes PvE, PvP, everything in between. Player cooperation, AI cooperation perhaps in the future, all these sort of things. Now, when you've got a very particular, specific subset of the community who all their feedback that's directed towards BSG, all of their feedback is extremely biased. You know, these changes are ruining PvP. These changes are making it so I can't run to the same exact loot spot every time to get, you know, masses and masses of graphics cards to sell on the flea market. When you've got these people constantly and loudly repeating all this stuff, it will get heard by BSG. Okay? Now, the last thing that should happen to the game, in my opinion, and this is kind of where a lot of the tweet sort of lies in my mind, like, a lot of these guys who want this fast-paced action, who want this very predictable run to spot A, grab very specific loot, PvP at this particular location, you know, survive, die, rinse and repeat, this, you know, this very, very predictable gameplay loop in that sense. I do feel that a lot of the players that want this and want this to continue are relatively new to the game and to what the, and not entirely, you know, not haven't entirely got to grips with what the game is trying to be, what it is going to be, and the vision of Tarkov. Now that may be a coincidence. That, you know, that might be just sheer coincidence that we had a massive surge of players after the patch 12 popularity boom, who joined the game when it was at the height of fast-paced, predictable gameplay. Do you know what I'm saying? They joined, and that's what the game was like. But it hasn't always been that way. Okay, it hasn't always been that exact same gameplay loop. With those, you know, with all this super fast jumping around, flying off of buildings sort of gameplay that you might, you know, might not expect from a game that claims to be hardcore and realistic. Okay, so really what I'd like to do right now is I'd like to go through a few of the replies on the tweet and essentially, you know, give my kind of feedback on these comments. And unfortunately, there's a lot of kind of, well, you'll see what people are saying. I mean, obviously this kind of tweet is going to upset people, and I don't apologize at all for upsetting anyone. I really don't apologize for upsetting people. Like, if you are upset with what I've said, then that's unfortunate. You know, I guess I don't like the fact that you're upset, but at the end of the day, you know, this is just my opinion. This is just one player's opinion. I'm just a player. I'm just a Tarkov tester. You know, like, what I think in the grand scheme of things is largely irrelevant. This is just my one, if you like, take. Yeah, this is my take on the situation in general. And, you know, I'm not going to apologize for my point of view, because I believe, even if the message hasn't been put across as well as it can be, I believe that, you know, I truly believe in what I've said. All right, so let's have a little look and see what people are saying here. I'm just going to refresh real quick, because I think there's been a couple of additions. All right, so here we go. Now, first of all, Hyperrat. Okay, dying. You really said the game dying is the best thing to happen. I'm pretty sure if a company has a boom of popularity, its job is to ride on that wave, not the other way around. So, Hyperrat, fantastic Tarkov player, very, very popular content creator, has said, if a company has a boom of popularity, its job is to ride on that wave and not the other way around. So, my response to this would be, is that always the case, even if riding that wave of popularity is detrimental to the product itself? Okay, popularity doesn't always equal good or successful. It obviously depends on your definition of good and successful, of course. Okay, if something gets incredibly popular, let's say a product, for example, what we have here with Tarkov, let's say Tarkov ridden that popularity, BSG, you know, looked at the numbers, looked at what was going on, looked at where the game was going and why the game was so popular. They looked at that and then they go, right, we're gonna keep this going. We're gonna try and make the most popular FPS on Twitch. We're gonna try and make the most popular FPS on PC. Everything else. Now, my question to you is, what happens to a game when you try to make the most popular and most played game on any particular platform? What kind of games are out there at the moment which are the most popular? That's my question to you, okay? Would you say, for example, that Call of Duty is better than Escape from Tarkov because it's more popular? Would you say that Fortnite is better than Tarkov because it's more popular? Do you see where I'm going with this? Popularity doesn't always mean better for the product, doesn't always mean better for your project backers, especially those who have been there from pretty much day one, okay? You know, more popular doesn't always mean a better product, okay? Sure, it might mean that more people are using that product. It might mean that more people know about that product, but that doesn't always mean that the product has achieved those aims that it set out to achieve from the very start. Okay, you might say, well, visions change, aims change. And I absolutely agree with you. Yeah, things do change over time, of course, especially when something is in development for so long. You're absolutely right. Okay. Now, whether that product changes for the better or for the worse, well, that's subjective. We all have our own ideas on what is better or what is worse. Okay. Now, for me personally, I believe that if Tarkov was to go the way that it was going, and you know, it continued to be super fast-paced, it continued to be really a shadow of what it used to be in terms of how the game was played and how people felt about how the game should be played. Now, needless to mention the whole Chad and Rat thing, right? You know, if the game continued to go that way, we would eventually end up with another Call of Duty. You know, everything that made Tarkov great to begin with would be lost, and we would just have another COD clone. Does that make sense? And that is the last thing that I want for any Tarkov fan. I don't want any of us to have to experience another clone of a 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 formula that, you know, the big corporations know that works. They know exactly how to get money out of us. Yeah. Now, of course, it is worth mentioning as well, you know, I honestly don't care how anyone plays Tarkov. I don't care. You know, at the end of the day, the objective of Tarkov is to see her, right? It is to survive, evade where necessary, resist anyone that you come up against, and extract. It's as simple as that, okay? The job in Tarkov is to survive. You can't escape from Tarkov if you're dead, okay? I do not care if you are a fast-paced player, a slow player, tactical, immersive, competitive, you know, I just couldn't care less, man. You play the game the way that you enjoy playing the game. I respect that, man. If you're having a good time, as long as you're not cheating or using exploits, I honestly don't care. Okay, so it's not about that. Okay, it's not about that. What it is about is how vocal many of these players who have joined since it being popular are being about the development, the changes that are happening, the changes to the gameplay and the direction that the game is going. Like, Tarkov is going to become harder. It is going to become slower. It is going to become more tactical. It is going to be become more favorable for group and squad activity, because this is the original vision of the game, okay? And all I'm seeing is people fighting against that. They're fighting against progress. Now, we're getting to the meat and potatoes of my point. If it's the guys who are against this progress, if it's these guys who are fighting against the game becoming what it was supposed to become, if these are the guys that are leaving and losing interest in the game because it's not going the way that they want it to go in that respect, then perhaps that loss in popularity is for the best in the long term. That is the idea behind the tweet. That is the idea behind what I wanted to say. Okay? Again, I don't care how you play, but please do not stop Tarkov from being what it's supposed to be, okay? Let BSG make their changes. We're all here to test, okay? We're all here to test to see if those changes work. Not necessarily if we like those changes or if we think those changes are what will make the game, you know, more closer to its vision, okay? That's not our job to do that. Our job is to test stuff to see if it works. If it does work, awesome. If it doesn't work, let BSG know. Simple as that, okay? Yes, of course, we can express our opinions about things that we don't like, okay? But at the end of the day, BSG need to make their game. If they don't make their game, and they ask and they make the game that people are kind of asking for in many ways, it ain't gonna be Tarkov anymore. Do you know what I'm saying? It's not gonna be Tarkov anymore, guys. All right. And deep down, nobody wants that. Deep down, nobody wants this game to become another clone. Otherwise, you guys would be out there playing those games. You know what I'm saying? All right. That's the idea. I also think that one thing that we need to think about as well is we are still in a global pandemic, okay? I know it might not feel like it to a lot of people, but we are. A lot of people haven't yet gone back to work. A lot of companies are not yet working at full capacity. We do need to remember this. You know, a lot of people are saying, well, nothing's happened. Nothing's been developed over the last 2 years. We've been in lockdown for the last 2 years. Year and a half, if you want to, you know, split hairs. So players have had probably twice as much time, if not more, than they would usually have to play the game. They have more time on their hands to play. Okay? And on the other side, there is objectively less content with regards, you know, in respect to other wipes. Okay, there is less things being put into the game. There's less progress in that sense because of just how difficult it's been for BSG, you know, working from home, having to work remotely and essentially try and get stuff done from all over the country. Do you know what I'm saying? So players with way more time than usual. Developers with way less time and resources than usual. Put these two things together, it's a recipe for disaster. And that's what we're seeing. All right? That's what we're seeing as well. Okay? Let BSG make their game. Let them do what they believe is right. Because that's what they've done since the start. We've had a bit of a rocky period since patch 12. Perhaps BSG aren't getting the feedback that they really deserve to make their game. But with these changes coming in that are quite clearly moving towards what Tarkov should be and what it said that it was going to be, okay? We need to let that happen. We need to let that happen, guys, all right? Otherwise, again, we'll end up with a clone and nobody wants that. One last point, guys, and if you've made it this far, you're an absolute champion, and I really, really appreciate that. I know this is a very, very heavy topic, and if you've made it, you know, all the way into this part of the video, then you know you guys deserve a pat on the back. You know, I do appreciate it. Now, there's a popular misconception: the more players playing the game, more players getting into the game means more money to develop it. Okay. Now, if we cast our minds back to 2016 and beyond. It's always been quite well documented that the funding for Tarkov has always been secure. Tarkov was funded and budgeted for before it entered development. Okay, let's not forget as well that Battlestate Games' sister company, Absolute Soft, who are in charge of Hired Ops, which is a free-to-play first-person shooter set in the Russia 2028 universe. Let's not forget that that free-to-play shooter is most likely raking in a lot of money as well through its transaction system, and the way that that game is actually monetized. Okay, so this whole point of, well, if nobody's buying the game anymore, then development is going to stop, that's a non-issue. Tarkov's not the kind of game where you can just throw money at it and it makes itself. You know, we need to remember that BSG are people, a team of human beings developing this game. Like, it is down to these people to make the game. Okay, throwing money at Tarkov is not going to fix it any faster. It's not going to make it any better. You know, so it's not a case of more people buying into the game equals more or faster developmental progress. Okay, this is a common misconception that I see all the time. And it's simply not the case. BSG are working as fast and as hard as they can, they're expanding where they can. Obviously, being a Russian development studio, where based in Russia, working on a Russian game on Unity, it's a very, very small pool of developers that they have to pick from. Okay, there's a lot of criteria that someone must meet in order to be able to join BSG and be able to, you know, help them develop the game. Okay, it's not a case of just throwing money at the project. That's not, you know, that's not gonna help anything. And just as a closing point, guys, in my opinion, a smaller, more focused and more dedicated player base who are given the feedback and the reports that BSG need, in my opinion, is more useful and better for the game long term than a bigger player base that is a lot noisier and has a lot less focused and useful feedback for the game. It's a simple case of quality over quantity. Just something to think about. If you disagree with anything that I said, please feel free to put it in the comments. I know my tweet came across really spicy. I can be pretty spicy from time to time. I speak my mind. And, you know, I do look forward to hearing what you guys have got to say about it. If you disagree with me, guys, please feel free to reach out to me by DM or put it in the comments or whatever. You know, whichever way is best for you. I'm always open to chat about this. And if you can convince me otherwise, you know, if you can convince me that I'm wrong, then I am open to suggestion. Okay, I'm open to seeing what you've got to say. Guys, thank you very much indeed for watching this video. It's been a long one. I really wanted to do it in a few minutes, but I think there's a lot to say. All right, guys, so take care of yourself. And, well, I hope to see you soon. All right, thanks, guys.